Hey friends, did you know that Azure Search handles billions of search queries every month? Jacob is here to show us how you can add the AI-powered cloud search service to your mobile and web apps without hiring search experts that know what an inverted index is. I'm going to learn how today on Azure Friday. Hey folks, it's another episode of Azure Friday. I'm here with Jacob talking about Azure Search. You've got a couple of cool features and demos to show me today.
Yes, I am. So first, maybe a little intro what Azure Search is. It's not a search in an Azure cloud. Mm. It's search on your data. So you bring your data, you want to make it searchable. You have a website, you want to add this small search text box, right? And you know, these days, people are used to great search experiences. Like, you know, if you type a word and it will not find something that you meant, they are like, oh, this search is not good. So today, I want to show you what Azure Search can do for you. And my screen is already here. So like, you know, as usually, you start an Azure portal. Azure Search is like one of the search services. And the first question probably you have, like, how do I bring my data to Azure Search? Like, do I have to bring my data to Azure Search? Mm-hmm. The answer is yes, because we need to make it searchable. You need to create a search index. Mm. And search index is something like SQL table. So for example, there are two ways to do it. First is like you can directly upload it to search index, or if you have SQL database or Cosmos DB or Blob storage, we can import it for you and keep it in sync for you. So you can still keep your data in like SQL database, and then we can sync it and have it searchable in a search index. So like here I'm the Azure portal and I created a Azure Friday search service, right? Mm-hmm. And for example, if you click import data, we have this sample data source, which is real estate data on a SQL database. And I click next, and now we are trying to find out what do you have in your data. Mm-hmm. I'll skip the cognitive search for now, and then I'll get to the search index, what that is, right? So as you can see here, it looks like a simple table, right? So you have beds, baths, this is like
int.
Yeah, string. You can change it. You can change the properties, so on and so forth, right?
Yep.
And then once you're done, because I already went through this exercise, right, you end up in the search index that you can pretty much search. So for example, let's say I search for Medina. I want to find some house in Medina where Bill Gates and Jeff Bezos live. Mm-hmm. You know, so here you have raw JSON, but we also created open source tool that enables you to generate UI on top of this data. So mm-hmm. if you go to GitHub and search for AzSearch.js. We have this library there. You can take advantage of that. We have a website that will generate UI for you. Not much to do on your site. And you end up with something like that, right? So then when I search for Medina here, I can see the beautiful houses over there. But then let's see, okay, I don't have $4.5 million yet. Mm-hmm. So I'll just be, you know, I want an apartment, okay? So show me apartments, okay, 2.5, but let's be more humble, 2 beds. Okay, I found this Medina, 600K, cool. So this is like a, you know, one-on-one search experience you want on your site that is efficient, it's fast. But you can also do more cool things. So a few months back when the US government published the JFK files.
Oh yeah, I remember that. They were huge, a big dump of data that they had what's it called? They made it not confidential.
Yes, and that was mostly like images and PDFs.
Yeah, yeah.
Which, you know, it's a problem to go through all of it and try to match and find some information, right? But we were like, hey, why we don't put it on Azure Search? And that's what we did.
Really?
So we created this website, JFK Files. You can go there, jfkfiles2.azurewebsites.net. So you can guess there's probably
That's a pretty cool idea. Yeah, someone else, JFK Files 1, is out there somewhere. But that's cool. What a clever idea.
And then you can, you know, start your research. Like, what can you find here,
right?
But
hang on, though. You said it was blobs and images, and it's a big binary dump of stuff. How can you search that stuff?
Aha. So that's when the Azure Search comes in. Because, you know, our goal is not only to make textual data searchable, but also enable you to bring any types of data. And like what we did, like, so we have this GitHub account where we like kind of show the architecture of JFK files. When we put everything in Azure Storage, then we did our mechanism to extract this content from images, do OCR on them, and not do text analytics, use AI powered by cognitive services. So now when we did that and created the search index and then generated this site using AzSearch and did some polish on top of that, right? And then you can start your research. So for example, if I search for Oswald, which is the assassin of JFK. It outputs these documents, and also like we added the cool highlighting on top of that, so you can see like, oh, Oswald was mentioned here.
How did you look at that? That's a scribble, though.
That's how good the Microsoft OCR is.
Seriously.
And this is recognizing the handwriting. Yeah, and also like it's recognizing people in the images. So like for example, there's image of an Oswald, and it tagged it properly, right?
Wow.
And then you can go further. So what we did like entity correlations. So we have here the Lee Harvey Oswald. You see like Lee Harvey is correlated to Oswald. It's actually the same person. And you see there is this correlation to Duran. Like, and what is Duran, right? And then you probably want to search Duran. Who is Duran, right? And you can dig in here. So let me switch back to the view. And you see, okay, Sylvia Duran, Duran family. There was some investigation here. Sylvia Duran, Cuban embassy employee. Oh, so there is a Cuba in here. And also we detect different tags, different mentions that are there. So you pretty much like bring a lot of data. We make it searchable. You can explore it. And you know, before recording this episode, I was like, hey, Scott, Can you like share your blog posts with me?
Well, it's funny that you mentioned that because the thing is, I've been working on upgrading my blog. My blog is actually a 12 or 13 year old application. I've got 4,000 or 5,000 XML files. And when you made it at the very beginning of this conversation, you made the comment about how users have an expectation about how search works. My search that I wrote in 2002 was effectively string.contains. No fuzzy search, no clever search, no past tense. No, it's the state of the art 15 years ago. Mm-hmm. And in fact, if you look at the pie chart of the amount of work that my site does, about 20% of it's just search. I don't want to be in the search business. So mm-hmm. search as a service with the latest styles and cognitive services that can be applied to search, even sentiment analysis, all kinds of things I'd love to do on my search. If you can get me out of that, I could actually refactor via subtraction and 20% of my blog would just go away, and I just use search as a service, Azure Search.
Yeah, exactly. And as you mentioned, you know, like you don't want to be in the search business, right? And that's what the many people who want to add the search, right?
That's not what my app does.
Yeah, exactly. And people like end up with either contains or like they just use some third-party solutions that take them to Bing or to Google or whatever, right?
Yeah.
But you can do it very easily with Azure Search. And like, and what is another important thing is that you don't have to manage it, right? It's on cloud. We give you three nines SLA. We take care of all of the, you know, fuzzy searches or thing like edit distance when you have misspellings. We give you autocomplete. We give you suggestions. All of these things that you have spent like months or years, if you want to make it nice, we give you for free.
But I don't have a week to do that though.
Exactly, right? So you want to start fast, and you don't want to. You just want to have a simple search and okay. with all the search capabilities. So you know what I did with your. Because first I asked you like, oh, it would be perfect if it was like in a SQL database, right?
Yeah, and when you said, oh, give me the SQL, no, I don't. I gave you 5,000 XML files.
Yes, and what I did, I put your XML files in the blob storage, and so this is an example like how one of the XML files look like, okay?
Yep.
So it's a HTML encoded content in XML.
Yep.
So I was like, okay, I'll just put it on blob storage, and I'll go through this import data flow that I showed you before, right? So.
That's cool.
I created Hanselman search service. I said import data. Mm-hmm. And here I have the Hanselman blob storage and went through this wizard again. And then this output for me, the searchable blog, right? So I think it's cognitive block 3 because I also ran the people extraction and also I think organization and sentiment analysis, right? So for example, here if you search for Satya, right? Again, I get XML extracted data, which is, you know, not that fancy, but only just to show you like, okay, these are all the people that I found, like Tony Stark, Satya Nadella, Phil Hack.
These are all names you identified.
And these are mostly like real names, right? Then organizations, Microsoft, YouTube, so on and so forth, and also like a sentiment. And here's like a small caveat, because if you run sentiment on large articles, you usually get 0.5.
Right, right.
Because usually there is not something, you know, very, very extreme and you look at a large set of data. But if you run it per sentence, here you have a little bit more interesting thing. You can like remove the 0.5s maybe and then see like how positive it is. So it looks like you're talking pretty positively about Satya here.
I'm pretty upbeat. I'm pretty positive. I like to be. I say nice things about the boss.
And then, you know, I went to this AzSearch generator to generate the website. And then I put it on Azure websites. And this is your blog, you know? And I started exploring, like, okay, what can I find on Scott blogs?
How did you generate that, though? How did you generate that?
So here on GitHub, we have this tool called AzSearch.js, okay?
Okay.
And here's like a small website that we host that you can generate. You just put your service name, you put your query key. And by the way, we are moving this to Azure Portal, so you'll be able to do it with one button click.
Right.
You will get index.html because, like, believe it or not, this is just index.html site.
Really?
Not much more. Yeah.
That's amazing.
And very minimal JavaScript. And if you're interested how to do this, like, I wrote a blog post, Cognitive Search, Azure Search with AI on my blog. You can go to jj09.net. And here, step by step, I describe that, like, you go through import data, you use the real estate samples, you can use, of course, your data. And then, like, at the end, like, how do you generate this UI with AzSearch? And then how you can do, because by default, we show you the JSON output. This is what comes with the search requests.
Right.
But you can super easily, like, provide the HTML template, which looks, let's say, something like that.
That's cool.
And that's it. And you're done, and you have a searchable site, right? So first thing I notice here is that, okay.
How long did this take you?
This, less than 5 minutes, maybe. I think the longest part was uploading your XML.
Like, literally the longest part was waiting for it to upload.
Yeah. And then, like, you literally go through it, and you can do it in a minute or two. Then it syncs. And then you have that. And then, like, I spent some time in, like, finding your image and, you know, putting some consonants. That stuff took the longest, right? But the raw site I have pretty quickly. And then, like, you know, here I see, like, people. Okay, Carl Franklin. Yeah, I know this guy. Like, you did, like, Hanselman with him, right, at the beginning. But I was like, who is Travis Ely?
Oh, right? I worked with him at an organization. And he's a very talented engineer. And
that's what I found here, you know?
We haven't worked together in 10 years, but early on, he was doing so much amazing stuff, I would write about him all the time. That's an insight I never would have seen if I hadn't applied Azure Search to 20 years of content.
Exactly, because this blog post is actually from 2004, right?
Can you search for diabetes?
Sure.
Look at that. It's already auto-correcting, auto-completing.
And I probably did some diabetes web services.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, there's the first insulin pump, and you found it right away.
And look at this. Like, I literally didn't do anything with your XMLs. I let the Azure Search machine to extract all of this, and this is the raw context that we have in Search Index right now, and it nicely parsing the images, right?
Yeah, yeah.
And if you search, you know, for different things like, I don't know, ASP.NET, right? Because that's, and you have, like, you mean tutorial, server controls, JustNet, ASP.NET Core, maybe.
That's amazing.
Right? And,
picture of a giraffe.
Core giraffe. how cool is that, right? So all of this is for free. So if you just apply a little bit of polish on top of that, your blog is ready.
What's so funny about that is that you, in the process of making my blog archives searchable, have made an even nicer blog than my blog. And that's not even the point of Azure Search. So if you apply this to your business rules and for the data that you have in your SQL Server, folks are listening to this right now, the power that you could find, the insights that you could find inside of your existing data is huge.
Yes, exactly. And, you know, you don't have to use this UI generator. Like,
no, just shows you the possibilities.
You can use API directly. And,
indeed.
Yeah, and actually, like, if you want to see how the... where's my focus? F12, yeah. If you want to see, you know, how this works, right? So, for example, here I click search, and this is what you get in return, right? So you get these different search results with the search score. Mm-hmm. So you can see how precise this is what I found. You get the highlights, and you know, you get the sentiment, you get the people, organizations.
Full power.
And parsing is up to you. You can do whatever you want. And we have .NET SDK. You can do raw JavaScript. And then you can add the cognitive services. On top of that, you can analyze images. You can OCR them. You can detect people. You can detect celebrities. The possibilities are endless.
The possibilities are endless. Well, thank you so much for sharing those. I am learning all about the power of Azure Search. I thought I knew, but I didn't. There's even more there than you can imagine today on Azure Friday. We'll be right back.